Hey, this is Ray Dombrowski. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I use concrete textures to add distress to logos. And by the way, at the end of this video, I'll show you where you can get the concrete textures. And I'm going to start out by pasting in a logo that I have. And what I want to do here is I want to make it look like it's actually painted on the concrete. So I've just pasted it in as pixels. And the first thing I want to do is make a displacement map so it looks like the graphic sort of warps to the lines in the concrete and the little dimples in the concrete. So what I'll do is I'll turn that top layer off, do Command A, Command C to copy, and I'll create a new document and I'll paste that concrete texture into a new document. And with displacement maps, it's good to give them a little blur so when you use them, they don't look too jagged, and I'll show you what I mean. First, I'll give this a Gaussian blur, and I'm only gonna blur it about 1.5, 1.6 pixels. That way there's still a little bit of sharpness, but it's not gonna be too jagged. So I'm just gonna save this as displacement map. And I'm going to go back to my graphic here, and I'm going to select the layer that the logo is pasted into and go filter, distort, displace. And prior to this, I figured out the horizontal scale, -2 and vertical scale 2 works the best for this. And depending on the resolution, depending on the black and white levels of your displacement map, and depending on how far you want it to distort, you may have to adjust those numbers. And I will pick that displacement map that I just made, hit open, and you'll notice it's a very subtle effect. Let me zoom in a little bit. But you can see how the straight lines are just warped a little bit. And in fact, you know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back a step. And undo that. And I'm gonna try it again. I'm just gonna add a little bit more displacement. So let's try -3. And 3, and we'll use that same displacement map. You can see here it distorted a little bit more, and I think that's gonna be good. So the second thing I wanna do is I wanna turn down the opacity just a little bit, because you know, if you've got something that's weathered and it's painted on a surface, you're gonna see a little bit of the texture of the material underneath, and in this case, the concrete underneath. So I've just turned down the opacity to 86%. And the next thing I want to do is I want to add a little bit of texture that makes it look like the paint of this logo is worn away. And I have a pre-built brush. So what I'm going to do is go layer, layer mask, reveal all, and I'll pick a brush. So I've got that brush selected, and with your bracket keys, you can kind of size it up or down. But what I'm doing here is I'm painting into this layer mask, and whatever's black, it's just gonna take that away. And you can see it looks like it's kind of worn. And the other thing I'm gonna do, since this is a rectangular brush, I'm gonna line it up with the right angles in this and just take a little bit more away from this piece and a little bit more from this piece, and that way you just get a little bit of variability. It makes it look a little bit more real. And the third step, what I'm going to do is duplicate this bottom layer and actually drag it on top. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the levels by hitting Command L. And I'm just gonna take what's gray and bring it to a white. And also I'm going to desaturate that, image adjustments, desaturate. And I'm going to turn that into a multiply layer. And what it does is it just adds a layer of black on top at the darkest areas. And I'm going to turn that opacity down just a bit. And that's about it. So check out the links below the video to find out where you can get these brushes and textures as part of my free download of the week. Or if you missed that, just go and sign up for my email newsletter and you'll get this as part of Graphic Design Launch Kit. Thanks for watching.